So we have this Eternals trailer. It dropped like 2 weeks ago, I think, in the middle of our hiatus. And this one looks great because we've been talking for a few episodes about how we were like not sure what to expect, and I think I'm even mm-hmm. less sure. But it's just a very pretty trailer.
I have my theories about it, which we talked a little bit on a previous episode, just a little bit about some of the history and origins in the comics, and the little bit. I am no expert on the characters themselves. What I do know is that they're immortal protectors of the Earth. Mm-hmm. And when you look at the characters' names, it's kind of a spoiler for this aspect of it, but several mythologies were birthed from, you know, different cultures around the planet because of the actual characters, right? That these they've been around for, you know, 200,000 years or some ridiculous long time. And so I think in looking through, and I've seen a couple other commentaries on this where they dissect trailers, which I'm often not one to do that, but they point out several scenes. If you watch it in slow motion, you see what appears to be different epochs, different time periods, mm-hmm. the characters interacting in different, and so I feel like we might get origin story / different character arcs over different time periods,
mm-hmm.
and it's probably going to be kind of like a family drama with this.
I think this is going to, it's going to bring up the same question though that we had at the end of Zack Snyder's Justice League. The Martian Manhunter is like, no, wait, you wait for after two alien invasions to decide to get involved. It's the exact same thing. It's like these people's like, well, after two alien invasions and one crazy robot, I think we might need to help out.
That's
now.
Right. Yeah. For them to not have shown up during the Infinity War and Endgame, right? But who knows? Maybe that's a really good reason for that, right? We have yet to see.
Well,
trailers don't tell you much. They just give you an idea, I think, visually.
Well, bad trailers do.
Well, good point.
Let's watch this one, speaking of. You want to?
Sure.
I'm going to hit the wrong button.
To make this larger.
Directors love that shot.
I don't know if we're in.
Yes, this is like ancient civilization here.
Yeah, possibly. And not sure if that's supposed to be a celestial ship.
Listener.
Maybe, yeah.
I guess that's...
I thought the Celestials were giants.
The Eternals were... Yeah, they are. And I mean, it was my understanding that the Eternals were created by the Celestials, but...
Ah.
That seems to give the impression that they showed up on a spaceship.
Yeah, maybe.
Who knows?
Unguided.
I love that synthesizer music.
Progress. Unseen them. Accomplish wonders. Throughout the years, we have never interfered. Until now.
Yeah.
Thank you for this.
Oh, you're welcome.
So now that Captain Rogers and Iron Man are both gone, who do you think's gonna lead the Avengers?
I could lead them.
Good stuff.
Yes.
So, someone cleverer than I pointed out the strangeness and sort of circuitousness that is Richard Madden and Kit Harington apparently having a part of the story arc is, you know, Kit Harington being a, I think the character he plays in this film is just a vanilla mortal, you know, just vanilla human.
He's playing the Black Knight.
That's right. Right. As a Dane Whitman. That's it. The Black Knight character, who is, he's human. He's not an Eternal, but having a fling, being romantically involved with Angelina Jolie's character, who's Athena, or just Thena, I think, mm-hmm. and who historically was a love interest for Richard Madden's Icarus, his character. And so you've got two of the Stark brothers in a love triangle with another character named, not Athena, it's Circe.
Right.
Which I think was played by, I'm going to have to open up the IMDb page. I think it's
she was the one. Jemma Chan. Way, Angelina Jolie was narrating.
She's playing
that,
Athena.
Right,
that's right. Is it Jemma? Is that how you pronounce it? Jemma Chan? Playing
the role
of Circe.
I haven't heard of her before. I'm sure I've seen her in stuff, but I just can't remember what it was.
Anywho.
Oh, wait. She was in, wasn't she in, she was in Captain Marvel. She played one of the Ronan's crew, I think.
Oh, yeah, Minerva. That's right.
Yeah.
Yep. Who was a longtime Captain Marvel villain. So that's interesting. So she's going to play a completely different role. She'll be the second person, at least in MCU, the third, if you expand out to all movie studios. We had that conversation recently where you've got different actors who have played different Marvel Comics characters in different films.
Some of them played both DC and Marvel.
That's right.
I love that guy. What is his name? I can never pronounce it.
Ian. Yes. Talked about that show.
So this is interesting. They are, in the DC universe, you have the old gods, which are like Zeus and Thor and all of those. Those are the old gods. And then you have the new gods, which are the Apocalypteans, most famously Darkseid.
Right.
But the Eternals seem like they're older than the old gods. Like, they're older than the Asgardians. So they're like the old, old gods. And all of these were created by Jack Kirby. So,
right. And I don't know that so. And the interesting thing there is that to call them gods, I think, is more based on human mythology, right? I don't know if these are beings that ever claim to be gods, right?
It's just. Well, the Asgardians love to claim that.
Well, sure. I was talking about the mm-hmm. Eternals. I don't know. We'll see.
Yeah.
If I'm Maybe not
they don't have a concept
mistaken,
of
they're related to like their foil. Right, they're sort of villains, like if you want to call it that. The foil of the Eternals, at least in the comics, were the Deviants, which are, I think, their sort of counterparts who went bad at some point. And if I'm not mistaken, I mean, Thanos is a Titan, right? But he was he's related to them in some way.
Well, I mean, you would think so, since Thanos was like, we need our own dark side, so they made Thanos.
Right. Thanos, just looking at the, Marvel Comics, Wiki, the Marvel Comics online, their database. Thanos is actually an Eternal in the comics, in the continuity. Some of Thanos' backstory has been explored in the Infinity War, right? Movies could dive into that, but, based on the original story written by Jack Kirby, the Eternals tells the story of an ancient group of immortals who lived on Earth for thousands of years. The Celestials, right, were their creators. The Eternals created to battle the Deviants, who in the comics are their greatest enemies.
And they didn't show bad guys of any kind in the trailer, didn't seem like. It seems like,
it didn't seem
like. They're saving that.
Yep. Something I know very little about. I don't claim to be an expert on the Eternals, but one of the Eternals appears to be a child. Even though,
I think that character's name is like Pixie or something like that.
Sprite? I thought it was Sprite.
Sprite? Something. It's one of those mythological fairy kind creatures,
right? But it seems kind of cruel. right? Be thousands of years old and trapped in the body of a 12-year-old.
Entire plot behind Interview with a Vampire.
That's exactly right, Anne Rice. Right, and eventually it drives her crazy for good reason.
I love that scene.
Yeah,
too.
I don't know whoever conceived of
naughty
that.
Naughty girl.
It feels like an ill-conceived plot point, plot element. Well, definitely looking forward to that.
Yeah, they're going to run into the Shazam problem with that, aren't they? Unless this is a person that's like Tom Holland that's actually 25 but looks that age.
Right.
Because Shazam, they're like, we can't wait 5 years to film a sequel because the kids are going to grow up. And then it's just, it's going to get awkward when Billy becomes an adult. And why when he turns into... I mean, I guess it would just be Zachary Levy the whole time, or is Shazam literally a different person? Have they ever done the adult Billy in the comics, I wonder?
That is a great question. We'll table that for next one.
Yeah. But, so I'm pretty stoked for this.
What do we know about... I was going to look real November. Quick at Eternals. What do we know about... is it Chloe Zhao? I'm probably butchering her last name.
Well, she just won Best Director in the Oscars.
That's right. Was that Nomadland?
Yeah, I want to say so. I didn't watch the Oscars this year. We actually got rid of regular TV. We finally were like, you know what? We use it to watch the Super Bowl and the Oscars, and it's just not worth the $8 a month. Because all we had were the regular channels. We didn't have any of the extended channels. So, yeah. It's Marvel's first Oscar-winning or nominated director for any of their movies.
Yeah, she was nominated. I don't think she won, did she? Did she win?
No, she won.
She won. Oh, she did. Yeah, with Nomadland. That's what I was thinking with Frances McDormand. Yeah, yeah. Okay.
So that's going to be
Should be pretty stunning. I mean, just visually based on the trailer. And again, trailers can be kind of notorious for showing you teasing some of the best looking stuff, some of the best lines in the movie. MCU is not known for that, honestly. The MCU trailers, they're really good at just giving you a little taste and save all the good stuff for the movie.
Yeah, they're also going somewhere that MCU hasn't really done. Is with visuals. I know a lot of the DC fans are specifically Snyder, how he uses color and all of that. And even, I almost called him Pony Smasher because that's his Twitter handle, David Sandberg and Shazam and the way they use the colors there. And then you watch Civil War and the big fight is in this airport and it's just gray. Like, there's no excitement visually to it. We finally got that. And that's why I think Infinity War and then Endgame are so great, as you have, and all the James Gunn and the Taika Waititi. These people are coming in and they're really expanding the palette.
Oh, yeah.
And this looks like it's going to do it as well.
Especially James Gunn. I mean, you can't debate. We recently rewatched the Guardians of the Galaxy films, and they're extremely colorful.
Yeah.
The first one especially, but yeah. Very visually stimulating.
You know what? One of the gigs that got James Gunn's foot in the door?
No.
He was a co-writer of the script to Zack Snyder's Dawn of the Dead.
Oh. So you may have mentioned that before.
Yeah.
Now that you say that.
Okay. But, so, that's the Eternals trailer. I would say we're on board. And, after our next clip, we got to talk about